Comedy Theater. Please put your hands together and welcome your host to the stage.
Theater. This show is called Local Legends. It is our longest running show. It's a slightly different improv show if you've ever seen. Who has never seen an improv show before? Let me hear you say, woo!
Woo!
Who has seen an improv show? Let me hear you say, ah!
Ah!
So nice. So a pretty good mix. Improv is like acting, but we're making it all up on the spot. So it's like writing, but you also have to act it. It's like both those things. If you've never seen any improv, welcome. If you have, also welcome. There's not a difference. Not welcome if you've seen it before. Oh, jeez. Because nobody has seen this show before. That's what makes it improv. Boom. Circle back around. Guys, this is our longest running show. It's called Local Legend. What happens is somebody comes up on stage. They tell stories about their life. We do improv based on those stories. There's not just me, there's a couple of other people back there. But first, some ground rules. We can't hear you and see you and smell you, which is nice, but also silence your phones. And the smell thing, like really, just keep it in like normal bounds. Worth saying.
How?
Maybe. How? Too late for that question. You are in public. And that actually brings me to another point. You don't have to shout out. There's another person that's gonna be telling stories and gonna be still doing improv, so we're good there too. Thanks for being that example. I paid him earlier. Other than that, beyond that, guys, this is a live show with a storyteller. Did I tell you who the local legend is? Of course I didn't. It's Heather Detzner. She is a Spartanburg Community College educator. She is a writer of children's books and other books. And she'll tell you all about those books. She is a mother, an improviser, personal friend of mine. Guys, Heather Detzner is great. Give it up for Heather Detzner. I realize that sounded like come up and tell a story, but we haven't got the rest of the cast out. So first, can I get you guys, just to get warmed up, let's get like a really, like the quietest clap you can make. Just like this. Yeah. Like quiet, like is someone clapping? Or is somebody walking very fast? Right? Let's like crank it up just a little bit. Like on the little dial, let's crank it up to here. Like, oh, okay. All right, someone's clapping, but it's in the other room. Okay? We're gonna crank it up to about halfway, like a normal clap. Like you're not excited, but like you have to clap because it's like a thing that you have to do for. Okay, let's crank it all the way up. Oh, this is like really excited. For me, we're here for Heather Detzner.
I'm Heather Detzner. Hopefully, you got some swag out front. Hopefully, you got one of those little cards that has a beautiful little girl's face on it and kind of me on the side. But that little girl's name is Esther. Call her Queen Esther, or the Quiet Queen, because she is very quiet. And the reason she is because she has something called Rett Syndrome. And basically, in a nutshell, Rett Syndrome is very random genetic condition, just completely spontaneous. But because of that genetic mutation, or one of her genes didn't copy correctly, she has a hard time telling her body what to do. So she can't talk, she can't walk, she can't control her hands very well. But she's insanely smart, insanely sweet. She understands everything people tell her. She just can't, you know, tell her body to respond. But she has a lot to say, and she's slowly but surely communicating more, and there's different ways we can do that. But I could use this whole show to talk about how much she does and how much she's learned. But she is wonderful. So she's, again, Queen Esther, and very smart. She loves elephants. We just learned recently her favorite color is green. Because I was asking her, you know, is your favorite color red? Is it yellow? I got to green. She got really excited, and consistently she's been giving that reaction. So she's aware. She loves being sassy characters in books. Her teacher recently informed us of that, because we didn't know for that before. But when they're pretending in their classroom to be different characters, she always chooses someone like the big bad wolf, which makes me so happy, because that's my thing. I love being like the weird, mean, sassy characters. But she also likes silly names in kids' books. So Reginald von Hooby Dooby is one of her favorite names in kids' books. But the first story I wanted to share is basically the first time I started to feel like a human again after getting her diagnosis of Rett syndrome, because obviously that's a bombshell phone call. And it was a phone call because we were going to leave town for Thanksgiving that next week, so the geneticist wanted to make sure that we knew this, that he didn't drop that on us, you know, like right afterwards. Otherwise, they would have told us in person. But anyway, so obviously a hard phone call to get. I was also in my first trimester with my third child, so I was having bad morning sickness, feeling awful. Just, it was a rough, that was a rough week. So basically a week after that, first kind of glimpse of some hope that I started to feel was at a Thanksgiving dinner. That whole week I'd just been basically crying and chugging ginger ale, because that was not fun, and I hate ginger ale so much now. But that was like all I could have. But it was a really sweet dinner. Esther was eating, I was giving her this peppermint ice cream, which I was giving her a lot of because it was one of the first times she was like really eating ice cream. It was usually too cold for her. And so I'm giving her this, she's going to town on this ice cream for like 20 minutes. I realize after that, my husband, give it up for Ryan. My husband's also been giving her this cherry cheesecake. The whole time she's been going back and forth between these two desserts, having the time of her life. And I mean, we would have given her as much as she wanted anyway, but that was the first time that I started to feel like, okay, this is hard, this sucks, but we can still be fun, have regular, funny little moments like this.
Thanks for that fun ice cream, Dad. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, no problem.
Mommy, mind if I had just a small bite of your cookies?
Hey, what?
Sure. Uncle John!
Hey! Come here, who brought you on? Yeah!
Grandma.
Oh, hello, child.
You look so great. You gonna finish that cheesecake?
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
Thank
please.
You. Hey, oh, you look great, by the way, for the holidays.
I wouldn't have shared my ice cream if I knew you were going to be going around to everybody else getting bits of theirs.
I'm working the crowd, you know?
I can't see that.
Hey, waiter.
Hey,
Can you, I'm having a kind of a day.
Ginger ale.
Yeah,
waiter, I'll have a Tom Collins.
We don't have that here.
I'll have a julep spritz with a twist. I'll have a
ginger ale.
Ginger ale.
Ginger ale.
All
right. Ginger ale, make one adult.
Really, it takes the edge off.
Oh, okay.
I come here multiple nights a week just for this.
I feel that I was given good advice. So hello.
Super fizzy ginger ale just overflowing the cup.
Really amazing.
I order a double, so I don't end up getting a single serving.
Really? I'll have to order a second. Yeah. Well, hello, friend. What brings you to the bar here?
Well, my girlfriend just broke up with me.
Oh, no.
I decided to drown my sorrows in ginger.
Oh, truly, that is a disappointment.
You sound very fancy.
I'm Baron von Schubidu.
Going down the tubes, all right?
Yeah.
All the major TV networks, they got all the big sports games.
That's true.
We got nothing to air on the weeknights.
Okay.
We gotta give something people something to root for.
All right, well, pitch me some ideas, because
okay.
I got nothing.
All right, an iTunes visualizer where people root for their favorite colors. Right? Let's make Roy G. Biv something people can root for, you know?
Super Bowl.
Oh, geez.
And this is on I'll be team yellow. If you want to pick another one so we can like have that.
Yeah, I'm not really sure what all the colors are yet, so I'm just gonna kind of wait until I can come back. Cut
to 15 minutes later.
Kill dog! Both you guys in the photo. We're gonna do a little quick photo session. All right.
Yeah.
Just get close together.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Great, sir. Are you? By the way, you are great. You look great today.
Thank you.
Yeah. It's really, really, really good. You, I. Thanks for coming out. You know, I'm going to move you around. It's going to move you around, make it a little more, yep. Okay. A little more natural. Can make right, it a little more natural?
Sure, yeah.
There we go. Yeah, there we go. All right. Yeah. You know what? I want you to put some of your hands there. With your helmet. There you go. A little higher. There you go. No, don't move your hands, please. Don't move your hands. Okay, great. No, you're, I can see the holes in their hands. If you could, thank you. Okay, you know what? Let's just try this. I think there's like a reflection here. If you'll just stand right here.
Okay.
Yeah, and you're upsetting the baby, okay?
Okay.
Yeah. I'm going to give you this baby. It's a baby we keep here. Oh, that is great. That is great.
I feel like I'm not even in the picture anymore.
Yeah, you're not. You're not. You done some modeling?
That's okay. We'll get my solos afterwards.
Okay.
Or...
Okay, you're right. Thank you. Yeah, that was really, really
what a great baby.
Good. Yeah, if you want to, I'll get a couple of you.
Okay,
if you want.
Yeah, sure.
Cool.
Yeah.
All right, great. That's great. All right, we're done.
I was looking at my feet.
Yeah, we want less.
Well, face. This is actually my good side. Can we do one more?
That's your good side?
Yeah.
What's your bad side?
This one.
Let's get another story from Heather.
Going back to Esther after, that was wonderful. I don't know how much she's going to be able to do, you know, as she gets older, but she does continue to learn new skills, which is so exciting to see because she works so hard at everything that we just take for granted and assume, you know, or, you know, when you have a baby, you assume your kids are going to be able to walk and talk and feed themselves. So when she does learn even just a small new skill, like wrapping her hand around something or reaching for a toy, it's so exciting. And the symptoms didn't show up at, you know, with girls and boys with Rett syndrome, they usually show up about 6 to 18 months. So when she was first born, you know, just perfect, beautiful baby, just like she's perfect and beautiful now. But just a funny story from when she was first born. She has an older brother who's 6, and he loves her so much. But when she was first born, he still loved her when she was first born. But he wasn't quite 2 yet. So in that whole first month, I had to keep like a hawk's eye on him because he would just come running from wherever he was the second I left the room to throw a toy at him. And I think he was just, you know, he was being almost 2. And we had to make this barricade like around a pack and play where it was like a moat of, there was a baby gate and then we had a net over the pack and play. And I would still hear him just going, and it would just be throwing toys on top of the net, and it would be like going over the barricade, and it was just very funny. Not at the time, it was very frustrating at the time, but as she's grown up, you know, it's really sweet to see her relationship develop with her older brother and younger sister Lucy, and also very exciting when she does learn a new skill. I have a friend here who her kids and our kids play together a lot, and they were over when she first sat up for the first time on her own, which she'd been working for like so hard. She'd just been doing this rocking thing for about months and months and months, and she finally got to the point where she could sit up on her own. And all of us were just so excited, dancing. We were playing this this song. If you haven't looked up 80s aerobic championship videos, it relates, because we were playing a song from that called, it was like the champion song. Just type in champion 80s aerobic video, it's worth it, because they're just like, but anyways, we were playing that song and just, you know, getting so excited. And there's so many other little things, like she said I love you for the first time last month.
Yeah.
Same friend heard it on the, I didn't hear it at the time, I had to hear it as I watched the video again, talk about like a technology age situation there, where just in the moment it sounded kind of like a, I forget how it was, like I love you. But I could hear it pretty clearly on the video, but it was just so sweet. She's hugged me. There was one time we were just kind of, like, I was giving her a break from the car seat during a road trip and had her standing up against me, and she actually wrapped her arms around, and so that was really sweet because it's, you know, we know she loves us. She knows we love her, but to be able to show that physically is just absolutely amazing.
Yeah. Have a seat.
Yeah, yeah.
So you've been called in because Jennifer from marketing says that you charge into her office and throw they've erected some sort of a netting around her desk to protect her, but you continue to throw office supplies.
supplies at her. Clearly, you know this is not acceptable.
That's what's unacceptable?
Yeah.
I was waiting for you to get to the part where I did something wrong.
What is your problem with Jennifer?
I don't have a problem with Jennifer.
You loved her when she was an intern.
Yeah. No, I just want to make sure she's ready.
Exactly.
Cool, so John, get that paperwork back to you, and I'll put it right here on your desk. Is that okay?
Yeah, sounds good.
Cool, great, thank you. Boat. Ha-ha! Stapler!
No! How does this keep happening?
I was in the vent!
What do you want? What do you want?
I want you to be ready for anything, and clearly you're not, because the vent was so easy to unscrew.
Can you seal it closed?
If I have to explain it, then how are you ready to be a full employee?
I feel like that wasn't a no, because you know that that's your last method of getting in here.
Is it? One day later. Yeah, so just put this back on your desk. Sorry again, I felt like I had locked everything last time, but I'll make
it's
sure.
It's okay, it was the vent this time.
Oh, okay, cool. Wow, that tiger cage they put up against it.
Yeah.
I'm sure that'll be
so
fun.
So he comes in, he'll be able to get in a little bit, but not the whole way.
Yeah. Boop. Okay, great, yeah. Boop. Shh. More bees.
So glad we got the bees.
Ceiling tiles! Paperwork!
That one cut me, man.
I'm really dehydrated because I couldn't... They sealed the top wall, so I had to just stay in here the whole time. Since last night.
Yeah, don't go in the vents if you're gonna leave that way, because we did get actually a tiger.
Oh, God! When he said tiger cage, I thought...
You got a tiger cage.
Yeah, when you said it, I thought there was a tiger cage, like a cage the size of a tiger.
No.
There's
no.
A tiger in it.
We got bees.
I think she's almost ready.
We have moats. You're not her supervisor. What is she ready for?
Anything. That's what this job takes. I'm gonna take lunch.
Okay, see you later. Jennifer, I need you to come in, please.
Now you are doing this?
Wait, maybe he's right.
A lifetime of training has all led to this. Aerobics World Championship 86. This is my year. Gonna win. Aerobics Championships begin. Signature move. Signature move. Signature move. Signature move. 20 years training in a dark cave just to whip out this aerobics, save and win!
Guys,
whoa!
Oh my gosh, sorry, I supposed to let you know that
I was in the middle of my routine!
Sorry, President Reagan was just shot.
What?
Is he okay?
Yeah, he's gonna live, it's fine. And just
you are direct-
get out of here, I was in the aerobics world championships! Anyway, there I was in the cave, perfecting my aerobics form. And what do I see but my spirit animal coming from the cave to guide me? That's right, guide me, little ocelot, to aerobics.
Guys, guys, guys.
What?
Oh my gosh!
First, he just interrupted us to tell us
he better be dead. That's okay.
No, I feel like I gave you bad news last time, so I'm gonna give you good news this time.
Okay.
You guys know what a Nintendo is?
Nintendo, okay.
No, what is it?
You know how you can go to the arcade?
Sure.
This time the arcade comes to you.
Whoa.
Right? Right?
All right. Yeah. That's kind of valid.
Mm-hmm.
You want to join?
The dance?
Yeah. Just sing whatever's in your heart.
Jump!
Jump.
My name is Mario and I'm here in your world 1.1. Gonna go across the street,
what?
Gonna have some fun, fun,
oh
fun,
God.
Fun. Gonna jump.
Guys,
on turtles. What?
The president of Nintendo's just been assassinated.
Those are all real facts, though. Those are
yeah.
all. President Nintendo really was assassinated.
I learned something a minute after.
Yeah, with Reagan and then the president of.
Yeah. That was just so enjoyable. Okay, so one of my favorite kind of quotes is actually from another girl who has Rett syndrome. Her name's Molly. I've never met her, but I've seen an article written on her, a couple interviews with her. She was valedictorian of her graduating class and is currently in college, and she communicates mostly through an eye gaze device that Esther has that she's learning to use. But this other girl has, you know, kind of perfected this, where she has designed things like scientific designs, and it's incredibly inspiring. But she had a line in her valedictorian speech of there's room for everyone at the table, and obviously that speaks to me a whole lot, because our whole family is just all about inclusion. We include Esther as much as we can, and a lot of it's not super intentional. We just kind of do it. We have a standing frame that we use outside to, you know, keep her more involved when, like, the kids are running around in the yard, so she can actually stand up, even though, like, she can't on her own. She can in the stander. And her brother and younger sister are just, you know, she's always present, she's always there, she's literally, you know, room for her at the table. And it's just, it's sweet to see, like, how our kids have learned to communicate with her by touching her hand, her touching our hands. She can make choices, so, like, she chooses our movie every other week, that we have, like, a family movie night, and she can choose a movie by having a few choices, and she'll kind of touch the one she wants. And but also with keeping her included, because it used to be that a child like Esther wouldn't really be included, or at least it would be harder to, just because the whole mentality around kids with disabilities has, thank God, changed so much that there's so many services, there's so much more opportunity to include our children. So it's sweet to see, when I first took her to a daycare, she was just turned two. It was an amazing daycare called the Wonder Center. I have another friend here whose daughter went, they shared a classroom. And the first time I left her there was hard, because it was the first time I'd, you know, been away from her for, you know, a whole day, let alone even just a few hours. So when I left her there and we were leaving, it was just really sweet, because I was feeling, you know, kind of guilty and a little nervous. And my son, who was about four at the time, goes, "I miss Smoochy Face," because that's what we called her. It was just so sweet. I love that quote about there's always room at the table. There's always, you know, something that our children can offer.
I know it's Thanksgiving, but do you have a reservation
for the family table? Mm-hmm. For my grandma's table? Mm-hmm. I didn't call ahead.
Yeah, maybe you should have, because we have a pretty lengthy list of people looking to get seats at
Is
this table.
Is there room at the bar?
Hey, are you almost done? Because I'd really like to get in before we start.
Well, what's your name?
Oh, I'm Uncle Dale. I called ahead.
Oh, Uncle Dale. Yep, you are on the list.
Thank you.
It's Uncle Dale! Yeah!
Room at the bar, or like at the chef's bar?
There's a wait list. You know, look, man, I know this is kind of a weird thing. I was just hired by the family.
Yeah, no, I get it.
Okay, all right. I'm gonna get stuck and get a smoke break.
All
right, man.
Hey, I'm gonna get another round of drinks.
You?
Oh, hey.
Hey,
Steven, what's up?
Apparently, I didn't call ahead. Can I get in at the end of Thanksgiving?
Yeah, how's it looking in there?
No, it's packed. It's not really up to me. It's got a grandma call, you know. You know, she's a little drunk.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Yeah. A little smoke break outside.
Cool. Yeah, cool. I'll be in there in a minute.
Yeah, I think they're bringing a plate out for me later if you want me to ask for a second plate.
Listen, I hate to ask. Is there room at the...
Is
room at the kids table.
Will your knees fit under the table?
They won't. I'm sorry, smoochy face, we're gonna have to let you go.
What?
Yeah, unfortunately you're getting fired.
What? Why?
Well, your performance hasn't been really up to snuff lately. And unfortunately we're gonna have to let you go, smoochy.
This isn't about my performance, is it, sir?
Of course it is.
This is about my other production.
Legally, it cannot be.
Well, that's what it is, right? That's just what all everybody in the office hasn't been telling me all day.
Your face isn't the same, Smooch.
Come on. What does that have to do with the cost of rice?
It's just that, you know, your name's Smoochy Face. I can barely kiss those little cheekies.
So what was that these last 35 years? Just a company mascot?
I mean, not on the books.
I did real work for this place.
Sure, yeah, no, yeah, no. Uh-huh. But, like, I mean, we don't call you Worky Face.
Hey, Boston Pants, I got that review for you.
Thank you. That's great. That's very good.
Yeah. What's going to happen to you, huh?
What do you mean?
What's going to happen to you?
I already got promoted.
When you're no longer a 5932.
Oh, come on. These pants aren't going anywhere.
I know about that. They say fashion's cyclical.
What?
Yeah. Before you know it, high-waisted, well-fitting pants.
Oh man, I heard the last guy, you know, he was a little angry on the way out.
Yeah, that happens.
But I'm so excited to fill this role. If we haven't met yet, my name is Cutie Patootie.
Okay. I legally cannot check to see if your patootie's cutie. I'll take your word for it.
I'm not really sure what that has to do with working at a rice factory, but I'm happy to.
It's just how we do
take
things.
Take on whatever role.
I did have some paperwork in here in my boss's pants. Sorry, I gotta take the file folder. Alrighty. There we go. So that is just like all your basic,
oh,
you know,
awesome.
Where things are around the business.
I am. I'm so sorry. I already have a request. I know it's my first day. I don't fit in the desk chair.
Okay. Would your patootie fit on like a regular ball, like one of those like?
Yeah, one of those exercise balls would be great.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. No. Hey, Cheryl.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hey Cheryl, Cutie Patootie's gonna need a big ball.
like a size medium or a size large or a size extra large?
Wow, that's, I appreciate this accommodation.
Sorry, so your name's just Cheryl?
I was the first employee here. The culture's changed since I arrived. I used to work with David, Mark, Carol, and Janice.
These are humans you're describing?
Yeah, we all worked together, and then new leadership came in. Yeah, Stevie Weavy CEO. And after that, everything else just changed.
Hey, Four Eyes, I need some help.
Yeah, sure.
And you're like the most helpful guy here, yeah. So if you can just, it's the toner and the
paper. Oh, yeah, see, yeah, bye. Let's say it, Cheryl. Say that right?
Cheryl.
Okay, yeah.
I quit this job.